ओम श्री गणेशाय नमः, ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। एवरी एक्शन हैज़ अ कॉन्सिक्वेंस। टुडे लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट द रॉन्ग एक्शंस वी मे हैव डन इन आवर पास्ट लाइफ और वी मे बी परफॉर्मिंग इवन इन दिस लाइफ एंड द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस इट कैन हैव। टुडेज वीडियो इज ऑल अबाउट द कर्सेस वी मे इनकर ड्यू टू वेरियस फैक्टर्स, वेदर इट्स बिकॉज ऑफ हर्टिंग एनिमल्स और इट्स बिकॉज ऑफ ऑफेंडिंग अ गर्ल और अ लेडी, अ स्त्री, or is it because of abortions or bhruna hatya, or is it because we offended a brahmin priest or anything to do with brahma tattva, or did we hurt a cow or kamadhenu? What is it that we did and why are we suffering? Let us discuss the various kinds of shap or curses we may have incurred. This is Mekhla from pujas.in. Very often I see that many charts carry stri shapa. Now what is stri shap or stri shapa? It's basically when you invoke the curse of a lady or a stri. Unfortunately, English does not carry the meaning of certain words, like, you know, if I had to translate stri, I would have to say a lady, a woman, or a girl. But stri in itself means feminine gender, so it includes everybody, whether it's a young girl or an older lady, whatever. So basically what happens when you have a stri shapa is you will notice some symptoms. For instance, it could be something like you're not able to, like, especially men, they want to marry, they're way beyond the marriageable age and they're still looking for a girl. They're not finding a compatible soulmate or a companion. This is one thing. Second thing could be that they are married already, but they are just not happy with their wife. They are not happy with their married life. They are just leading a life for the sake of, you know, being with the woman and things like that. Another thing could be like a lot of women only trouble them, whether it's at work or in the family, some or the other problem, like, you know, like female colleagues at work can be troublesome, some friends can be troublesome. At home, it can be the wife or the mother or mother-in-law can create problems. So problems basically from women will come into the picture when you have stri shapa. So these are just some lakshanas, I would say, or you know, traits of problems that you may observe, and then you should know quickly, oh, I may have a stri shapa. That's when you need to get yourself checked and do some appropriate remedies. Now, I'll first tell you why you would have got a stri shapa. One thing is being abusive towards the lady of the house in your past life, or being abusive towards your mother, disrespecting women, aborting a female, you know, fetus. The moment you know it's a female, so I mean, in those olden days, I'm sure many of them have done this mistake. That also can cause stri shapa. Or like planning to have a child, and every time you have a child, you end up having a girl child, and you're again cursing that you don't have a male child. That can also cause stri shapa. And I need not even tell you, obviously, like physically abusing a woman, raping, those things, it goes without saying. Definitely, it is going to invoke the curse of a stri. So what is the remedy for this stri shapa that you need to do? One thing you can do is go to a Devi temple and organize 9 Brahmin Sumangalis to be there and offer them the bagina. So what is bagina? Basically, it's a thali which you arrange with all the sacred items of kumkum, haldi, sindoor, flowers, fresh flowers, so that they can wear it on their hair. And give them some good drink, like a nimbu pani, a sweet, especially sweet. And then give them some something to eat also, like a halwa or something you can make and take it with you. Offer it to each of them and give them navadhanya, give them a sari and blouse piece. And, you know, give all this, tell them, do their charan puja. So basically, like, wash their feet and consider them to be devis. Swaroop, and you know, tell them that you have Stree Shap and then you need their blessings and take their blessings. So this is very auspicious, especially when you do it to Brahmin women, because as the divine will, they are being ordained with the powers to bless you, to absolve the karma. This is one thing. You should also look at another option of doing the same process, but instead of giving a sari, maybe you can give some dress or something to a kanya, some small girls, young girls below the age of 11 or 12, before they would have attained their puberty. To such girls, you go and offer 9 kanyas, you offer the thali. Okay, so basically all the same puja items will be there, dhanyas will be there, halwa and juice will be there, all of that will be there, but just offer it to them as if you are offering to Devi, as Bala Tripura Sundari, because mother will come in the form of small innocent children because of their purity, and she will bless us. Again, they have the powers, and whether they understand or not as children, but you should tell them, because you're not talking to them, you're talking to the mother in them, the Devi Ma in them. So that, with that bhavana, offer all of this. So offer your pranams to them and get their blessings on a Friday. This is very, very auspicious and highly effective. Normally we have it as a custom, especially here in South India, that we do this regularly during Navratris. Okay, the Sharan Navratri or Chaitra Navratri, especially on Durga Ashtami, we do it. Why 9? Because they are symbolizing the 9 forms of Durga Devi. Okay, that is why it's auspicious. But I do see that in my Vaishno Devi temple in Katra, Jammu, they do it every day. I have personally witnessed it. It's such a beautiful experience. They do Kanya Puja and Sumangali Puja every single day. I've seen that. And it's really nice, because you consider every lady as Devi. So you are actually invoking the blessings of Devi that way. And you are actually doing prayaschit for all the abuses or whatever disrespect or whatever wrong things you've done knowingly or unknowingly in your past life. And you know what the best part is, when you do this, you're not only correcting, mending your ways, but you're also telling yourself that, you know, this is how you should look at a woman. So that's another good thing, no? Like, you just change your, the way you look at things. Okay, that was one thing. Next thing that I want to talk to you about is the Brahman Shapa. Now, what is a Brahman Shapa? Invoking the curse of a Brahmin. Normally people, they treat Brahmins also like any other, they're, you know, doing a business negotiation. They try to say, reduce the dakshina, you know, cut down the costs, you know, don't be commercial, this, that. What actually happens is, you should never do that with a Brahmin priest. Either you agree to do it or you don't do it. But don't do this discount and negotiation or a business deal, because when Brahmin priests do pujas on your behalf, they're actually helping you absolve your karma. Even if you are a billionaire and if you are ready to give them 1 crore, there is no rule that a Brahmin priest has to agree to take on some of your karma. Because when he's doing the process of jap or anything, no, it affects him. It affects him also. So for which he has to do prayaschit, he has to do Dashamsha Gayatri or Dashamsha Havan of whatever sankhyas of japa he's done. It's an effort that he has to do so that he doesn't get affected. Otherwise his family will not grow. He will not grow. So there is no rule that somebody has to do that for you, right? So your approach to a Brahmin priest should be more of gratitude than this kind of an attitude. That's one thing. Second thing is, you could have invoked a curse of a Brahmin by doing things like, you know, without your knowledge, throwing, meaning not consciously, but stamping or stepping on a Veda book, or throwing books around, showing disrespect to books. And we could have also done something like, some Brahmin has come for Bhiksha, we have given him stale food, or we've actually shunned them away. I'm not saying in this life, in the previous life I'm saying. So we may have done all of that. Sometimes even doing abortions, Bruna Hatya, also causes Brahma Hatya Dosha. So there is some overlap between Brahma Hatya Dosha and Brahman Shap also. Okay, so progeny will not grow, the family will not grow, there won't be progress. So, you know, somebody who's afflicted by curses, they cannot grow at all. The life will be just full of struggles and sorrow and misery, which is why getting blessings from them is very, very important. So what you could do is call them for bhojan, have an elaborate bhojan, like with lot of interest, with lot of shraddha, you offer them as if the Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar have come to, the Trimurtis have come and sought your bhiksha. Like how Anasuya fed the Trimurtis, that way we should have the power to, I'm not saying turn them into infants like what she did. She is a Rishipatni, she immense power. Pativrata, she did it, but at least with lot of interest and Shraddha, we can offer them the bhojan. Give them Dakshina also, give them Vastra as Dana. This is one process of doing it. And do their Charana Puja also, like we say Pad Puja here. In South India, it's called the Pad Puja, where you actually wash their feet and take their blessings, tell them that you need their blessings. And another thing that you could do is, depending on your comfort, your Ichha, your will, willingness, you can give them, you know, Vastradhan, or you can also sponsor education for Brahmin Vatus. Vatus are small young boys who are actually learning the Vedas to take up the profession of being a priest, you know, who want to engage themselves as priests. So that is, they are called Vatus. So, you know, you can sponsor their education, do Vidyadana, buy them books on Vedas and Shastras. You could also, there are some very God-fearing and Shraddhalus, you know, devoted devotees who give them gold, who give lands, who give money as Dakshina, fruits as Dakshina, whatever. There's no limit for Dan. So you can do any of that and get their blessings. So that was about Brahman Shap. Then comes the Go Shap. Go means Kamadenu, that is cow. So don't ever eat beef. Don't do Gohatya. That's very, very, very bad. You know, it really affects you in all quarters of life, so don't do that. It's just one simple thing, and remedy is to go and feed the cow every Friday at least. And also when I was talking about Brahmins, you can also do Godan, donate a cow to a Brahmin. It's very good because it helps him in his livelihood and he will take good care of it, he'll worship it, so that indirectly those blessings also will come to you. And coming back to Go, like, you know, Kamadenu, so please worship every Fridays. Offer jaggery, offer banana, offer rice, okay, and do puja, revere, respect, donate generously to all the goshalas. It's really beneficial. Then we have this curse of a snake. Now, when you have the curse of a snake, one thing for sure is that you'll have you can't conceive or have children in the family. That's one of the strong points that you need to observe. Second thing is also, you may have skin diseases which will not go even after the doctors have given you medicines. Your skin diseases will remain. That means you have a Sarpa Shvapa or Sarpa Dosha. Then of course in the chart we know through Rahu Ketu, we'll know that, okay. And so then again you have a problem. And many times what happens, why do you get this Sarpa Shvapa, is like you will be driving on a highway without your knowledge, a snake, especially a cobra, would have just passed by your tire and you would have actually crushed it or something like that. Then again, that also causes Sarpa Shapa. Then you want to construct a new house and that plot where you want to construct may have an anthill where the cobra is residing especially. So when you destroy that, that's bad. You know, ideally what you should do is you should lay sand around that, the anthill, and actually stand there and pray to the cobra or the sarpa, saying that sarpa means snake, please Nagadevata, you leave this place, I want to build my house, please find another house and bless me. Then it's different, you know, it will bless you and it will go. When it's going, its imprints will be there on the sand, so you know it has moved. That is how the ancestors used to do. Now we are not like that. We are no patience. We are doing one Bhumi Puja, formality done, destroy. That's not the way to go about it. That's very bad. You invoke the curse then. So that also has to be followed. Then another thing is, some people have a thrill. They think they are daring and, you know, they can do anything. They are not scared of snakes. They try to chase the snake out. They try to kill snakes. I know many boys who have done that. And I've seen how they yap around saying, oh, I've killed this snake, they've burnt snakes, they've done all kinds of miserable things. So, you know, all that without their knowledge, for fun, just due to lack of maturity, they have done all that, and then they suffer so much because of that. Financial difficulties and life full of struggles. That is another thing you should completely avoid doing. And what do you do instead as a remedy if you've already got Sarpadosh and you don't know most of it? Even if you pollute the land, sometimes they say that it invokes the Sarpa, Shap or Dosh. So what you could do is Naga Panchami day, you can offer milk and some rituals which some temples in South India perform. So that you can do, and that's called the Sarpabali Puja. Offering Nevedya, Nevedya offering to Sarpa, Naga Devatas. In the Ashwat tree, around that, especially in South India, we have lot of pratishthapana of these stones of snake gods. So there you can go and worship on a Saturday before 8 o'clock in the morning. It's considered very auspicious. And you could also donate silver serpent, Naga, to a Shiva temple on a Monday or to a Subramanya Swami, Kartikeya temple on a Tuesday. Once you do all this, regularly maintain yourself by going to a Subramanya Swami temple on a Tuesday. Every Tuesday you can just go and pay a visit and come. It really helps you. You grow and your family grows, especially children grow. You know, you get the Ashirvad of or blessings of the Sarpas. It's really good. Don't get into curse mode. Always get into their blessings mode. They will not harm you at any cost if you do that. Next comes the Pashu Shap. In general, animals. You know what happens is, many times people have selfish motives. I want to do Vashikaran to this lady. I want to do Vashikaran to that man. You know, this is how they have intentions. So by hook or crook, I need something. So they go to a Tantric. Tantric will say, chalo, this is going to happen, but you need to give bali of a goat or a sheep or a camel. I've heard all these kind of things. So then they'll say, give this much money, give that much money, and they pay and they do it. Now that is for a selfish motive. That can definitely invoke the curse of the animal. Second thing is eating beef. Please don't eat beef. I don't have to say anything beyond that. The third thing is when the animals are mating, if you disturb them, that also kind of invokes their curse. So never disturb. Don't pelt stones on any animal, whether it's a cow or a snake or a dog or a cat. Don't do that. Don't try to pelt stones or harm unnecessarily. Even if it's necessary, you don't have to do any of that. Okay, and instead what you should do is, you should try and offer them biscuits, like especially dogs, you know, biscuits or bread or bun, whatever you can. And for cow, I've already told you can offer jaggery and banana. Then you can give milk to cat. You know, all this is going to help. You know why? Because instead of getting into their curse, if you invoke their good wishes and blessings or gratitude, they will protect you. When somebody is doing a tantric attack, they will be the first ones to know. They have a separate, a different kind of a sensor. They're very, very sensitive. So they will take it upon them, and they will not let that negative energy affect you, which is why you should really nurture animals, and which is why the devatas had all the animals as their vahana. If you see Kartikeya, he had peacock as the vahan. Ganesha had rat as the vahan, mushik vahan. Rishabh was the vahan, or Nandi we say, was the vahan of Ishwara. Devi has the tiger, and in some cases lion also, some forms of Devi. So you see, all this is just to tell you that, you know, human beings are supposed to be blending with the creation, not act superior in any other way. In fact, when the rishis lived in the forest to do tapasya, all the animals were there. They never disturbed the rishis. They respected, they understood. In fact, in some rishis ashrams, even the cow and the lion or the tiger also would be together and not harm each other. Like that was the kind of cordiality there, because of the vibrations and the vibrations only, I can say, of the generated by the rishi. So we should be like that nobody is harming anybody and we are in peace. Now that is when we are really going to grow, instead of invoking the curse of an animal or a Brahmin or a stri. You know, I see So unnecessarily, like, you know, we're losing your sense of judgment or clarity or discrimination, trying to separate a couple. I've seen so many people calling and saying, you know, they're married, I want them to be separated because I want to be with the man. Whether it's a lady doing that or a man doing that, you know, you want to separate. See, if they only want to separate as a couple and then they want to marry you, then it's different. But you yourself want to, you know, actively do something, create misunderstanding between the husband and wife, so they get separated, so that you get an edge over one of them. It's not a good thing to do. All this is also stri shapa, because you're spoiling somebody's marriage. And if that stri is, she doesn't have to curse you, she may not even know you. See, I'll tell you how it works. If she may not know you, or she may not curse you and say, oh, this person did this, so I'm going to curse. It doesn't work. She may just cry. She may shed a few tears. That itself will become sharp. That will start affecting you. Because of you, somebody shed tears. That is the kind of himsa that she has gone through, and because of which you are suffering. See, finally, it's not you or me keeping the records. We have Chitragupta keeping the records of all that we are doing, all that we are thinking, and everything. These records are submitted to Yama after our death. So Yama will take an account and say, oh, ho, ho, you have done all these good things, you go to Swarg. You have done all these bad things, go to Narak. You know, that is how it is. So these are all prayaschittas to basically generate awareness that you don't do the same thing in the future, in this life. Because what you do in this life can also decide your future, right? So that is the whole idea. So I have seen so many people suffering, and I feel so miserable for them. Because of unknowingly doing all this, they are suffering so much. You know, like some people who don't do annadan regularly. Generally, you should have it as a part of your culture, isn't it? So you don't do annadan, you don't want to help another person, you don't feed others, you don't share. Such people have severe digestion issues. They would have done all this in their past. So in this janam, they cannot eat properly. They can't digest what they've eaten. If they want to get food, they can't get food on time. You know, even if they have tons of money, they can't eat on time. They won't have peace of mind to eat. All of this they'll suffer. So unnecessarily, I feel that, you know, you should completely avoid this kind of a life and get into a mode of grace and abundance and peace and happiness and prosperity. So hence this video. I just hope this video was informative, and it's going to bring in some transformation in the way you think and your approach to life. Invoke the blessings of the divine and ward off the curses. Thank you. Namaste.